Mozart to his father. Your last letter made tears of joy come to my eyes. You totally convinced me of your true fatherly love and care. With all my might, I will strive to deserve your fatherly love even more. But again, due to my ingeniousness, my lifestyle, you know that I, so to speak, am stuck in my music. That I think of it the whole day, that I like to speculate, study, think. I can't act any other way. I have to write a great opera or none at all. If I write a small one, I'll earn little. However, if I were to write a big one, the pay would be much better.
Thank you.
Most beloved of all fathers, how gladly would I not continue to sacrifice my best years to you in a place where I am so badly paid. If my salary were the only drawback, but to be badly paid and to not be scoffed, despised, and bullied into the bargain is really too much. For the Archbishop's concert, I composed a sonata for myself, a rondo for Brunetti, and one for Ciccarelli. At each concert, I played twice. And the last time, when the concert was over, I went playing variations for a whole hour with such general applause that if the Archbishop had any vestige of humanity, he must have been delighted.
Thank you.
extraordinary. On the page, it looked nothing. The beginning simple, almost comic. Just a pulse. Bassoons, basset horns, like a rusty squeeze box. And then suddenly, high above it, an oboe. A single note, hanging there, unwavering. Until a clarinet took it over and sweetened it into a phrase of such delight. This was no composition by a performing monkey. This was a music I had never heard, filled with such longing, such unfulfilled longing. It seemed to me that I was hearing the voice of God.
Thank you.
May 1st, 1778, to Father. If this were a place where people had ears to hear or hearts to feel and understood just a little of music and had some degree of taste, these things would only make me laugh heartily. But as it is, so far as music is concerned, I am surrounded by mere brute beasts. But how can it be otherwise? For in all their actions, inclinations, and passions, they are just the same. There is no place in the world like Paris. You must not think that I exaggerate when I speak in this way of the music here. Refer to whom you will, except to a Frenchman born, and if trustworthy, you will hear the same. But I am now here and must endure it for your sake. I shall be grateful to Providence if I can get away with my natural taste uninjured. I pray to God every day to grant me grace to be firm and steadfast here, that I may do honor to the whole German nation, which will all redound to his greater honor and glory, and to enable me to prosper and make plenty of money that I may extricate you from your present emergencies and also to permit us to meet soon and to live together happily and contentedly. But his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. with Constanza. I fool around and have fun with her when I have time, which is only in the evening when I dine at home. For in the morning, I write in my room, and in the afternoon, I am seldom at home. If I were obliged to marry all the girls with whom I've had a little fun, I should already have at least 200 wives. July 1781.
Thank you.
I cannot write much, for my fingers ache from writing out such a quantity of recitative. I hope you will pray for me that my opera, Mitridati Rediponto, may go off well, and that we may soon have a joyful meeting. I kiss your hands 1,000 times and have a great deal to say to my sister. But what? That is known only to God and myself. Please God, I hope soon to be able to confide it to her verbally. In the meantime, I send her 1,000 kisses. My compliments to all kind friends. We have lost our good Martel, but we hope that by the mercy of God, she is now in a state of blessedness.
Thank you.
Mozart to his father. Since death is the true final purpose of our lives, I have over the past few years made myself familiar with this true best friend of humanity, so that its image is no longer frightening to me. Instead, it is very much calming and comforting to me. And I thank the Lord that he let me have the opportunity to get to know death as the key to true happiness.
Thank you.